So, I'm gonna try doing a little different sketch. I wanted to work on some stuff that I was working on earlier. I used to draw these like robot figures and things that just kind of more technical and well, I guess it's not really technical, but more detailed. So, I'm gonna try doing one of those. I started one a few minutes ago, and it's just kind of a pencil sketch that I started. I'll go in and I'll fill in some of the detail and kind of turn it into something a little better. So let's start this out here. So I kind of went through with the pencil. I want to try, so these are a couple brush pens, and then this one here is a point 0.8. So I'm gonna go do some outlining with this, and it should bring this drawing a little more together. Then you'll be able to see it a lot better. So it's a four-legged robot, kind of like a, it kind of remind me of like a bird. Chicken style leg, but I just want to try something a little different. So this one was, I didn't really have any reference picture that I went off on this one. It was just kind of full, kind of like an imagination type thing. I used to draw a bunch of these when I was younger. And I just kind of started out with a bunch of circles and squares and stuff, and it was all like geometrical shapes, and put it together. Like I had to have like a base for the body, and then but I could use any shape depending on what I wanted for the robot. And I used to just doodle these just on kind of whatever. But this is the four leg, it's kind of like a, it's not a bipod, I guess it'd be a quad four legs. It didn't look like it would be that stable when I did it, when I drew it with the two legs. It was a little more top heavy. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna make it a four-legged, like centaur, horse, robot style. I don't know what exactly this robot's purpose would be. I didn't really give it any weapons or anything like that. It was just kind of a, he's got kind of like mittens. They're not even like full functional hands. But he could hold on to something, I guess. Pick something up or move something. I did give him radio antennas on the back here so that way he could communicate with, I don't know, his other workers or whatnot. So this is kind of the rough outline of him right here. I kind of figured it would be in some type of futuristic. So, I mean, there might be some rubble in the backgrounds, like I think I like some rebar and like maybe some concrete bricks or something like that that would be broken. Just some like debris and rubble, kind of like you'd be like a garbage man or something like that. I should be probably sketching this stuff out with
a pencil, but I wasn't too worried about the background stuff. It's not going to be as detailed, or it's going to be kind of more blurred in to the actual drawing. So like that actually might be okay. I was thinking more of like an I-beam setup, but I don't know how. Let's see. Kind of messed up on the proportions on that, but I think that'd be good. Okay, so this is kind of, maybe he like just jumped and like fell into the, I mean, I guess I could make this like a hole where he kind of broke through the ground. Maybe there was some bricks and like a brick walkway or something. And he just like kind of fell from the sky, or he jumped over something and just broke off this section of ground that he landed into. Yeah, something like that. And then I'll go through, and this was the 0.8 brush right here. I'm going to go in with my brush, this one here. So I got two brushes that just say brush on them. I don't know if they're actually different. Let me take a look here, because I haven't used these that much. So I think this one looks like it's a little bigger of a brush than the other one, so I'll use the smaller brush. I'm just going to go in and add some shadow and maybe a little bit of detailing on some of this stuff. So like he would have natural shadow under like the arms, and then since I'm just doing these pretty much in black and white, I don't really want to do too much, because it'll just take away from the look of it. But I think I'm going to do these panels on his chest, like they'd be black or something, or I don't know, I guess they could be any color, but since it's black and white, they're just going to look black. And then this, I imagine this to be kind of like a two stripes, like if you had like yellow or something on that. And then let's see here. So I want these eyes to be look like they're almost glowing, so I'll probably have to do black around here. All right, like that. There we go. Okay. Now I'll go in here and get some shading done behind, because I don't really want these legs in the back would be basically covered up, but I still want them to be there. Let's do black belt. Okay, now this here is all going to be black in. Okay, let's see here. So I'm liking kind of how that's looking. Yeah, so that's, I mean,
that's a decent little sketch for that. Just like a little robot kind of futuristic thing. And then I always go in and do my little signature thing, which is, if you guys don't know, it's actually my initials, but it makes this little elephant. And it's something I started doing a long time ago, and I'm trying to get back into doing it more. But it's the J and then the A and the M, just my little like signature thing. So yeah, I mean, that's just a little sketch, of a robot, something different. I'm trying to get a variation, because I mean, I've draw so many different little things, and trying to do some out of the box, because I do a lot of drawings of stuff that I actually am looking at, but drawing something that I haven't seen and something just straight out of my head, it's a little more difficult for me, because when I'm just drawing an object, I can just look at it and then draw it, but with drawing something out of my head, it's a little more tricky. So all right, thank you. I hope you like this video, and hopefully I'll be doing some more. So, all right, thanks for watching.